In a previous screencast, we discussed what a thermal boundary layer is and how we can use its properties to determine a convective heat transfer coefficient. So here we'll look at a thermal boundary layer that forms on a flat plate and determine not only that convective heat transfer coefficient, but also the temperature gradient through the plate itself and at the surface. So let's start by considering a flat plate. It has a thickness, and in conduction, that thickness that it goes through we call L, of 0.4 meters. And it has a thermal conductivity of 60 watts per meter Kelvin. And we have a fluid here that comes in. It's at a T infinity of 30 degrees C, and it has a thermal conductivity of 0.6 watts per meter Kelvin. And then as soon as it hits the plate, a boundary layer is going to form. And in this case, we'll get a thermal boundary layer because the temperature of the surface, which we'll call TS1, the surface that the fluid flows over, is equal to 50 degrees C. In addition, we have convection through that plate because it has a length of 0.4 meters, and the temperature at the bottom of that plate is equal to 150 degrees C. So what we want to find in this problem is that convective heat transfer coefficient. We want to find the temperature gradient within the plate, and we want to find the temperature gradient at the surface. And in this case, our y is going in this direction. Therefore, this is going to be the temperature gradient at y equals zero. So the first thing we'll do is use the energy balance around the surface of the plate to find our convective heat transfer coefficient. And what that says is the energy that leaves that surface, which is convection, and we'll use Newton's law of cooling to find the convection, is equal to the conduction that enters the surface. So since we have everything except for that H, let's go ahead and solve for it. And what we end up with is a convective heat transfer coefficient of 750 watts per meter squared K. The next thing that we want to find is the temperature gradient through the plate. And because the mode of heat transfer through the plate is conduction, we can write that our temperature gradient, dT dy, is equal to minus T2 minus T1 divided by that thickness of the plate, which is L. And so this temperature gradient is equal to minus 250 degrees C per meter. If we look at the surface of the plate, however, we have to use a different expression. Here, our dT dy, as we showed in that previous screencast, is equal to minus our heat transfer coefficient divided by the thermal conductivity of the fluid. Because if you recall, the conduction there at the surface is through the fluid. And this is going to be multiplied by TS1 minus T infinity. And if we put in the numbers from above, that's equal to minus 2.5 times 10 to the 4th degrees Celsius per meter. And so see what we mean about boundary layers being characterized by sometimes extreme temperature gradients. So remember that here at the surface, that's where those gradients are going to be the greatest.